What up, folks? KT here, back with another video. Today we are going to talk about barbers and the barbershop, and this is my top five reasons why clients hate their barbers. Barbers, you can respond, you can drop a comment down below, but this is the top five reasons why clients hate their barbers. So let me go back. I don't remember a time like this. You know, I was getting my hair cut for a long time, and growing up on the East Coast, Jersey, always had dope barbers. I just don't remember these problems that I'm dealing with now. Maybe they could have been happening, maybe I just wasn't too aware of them, but I just remember going to get a cut, get lined up. It was fresh. You leave it, you look, it was fresh. You got home, washed it, checked it, it was fresh. But since I moved to Arizona, I've been out here since 2007, I've had some barber problems. I got a couple other videos up where I talked about different little barber issues. Not with all the barbers. I had some dope ones, a couple. But you know, you move, they move, something happened, and you can't, it don't work out. Like right now, I want to get the barber I used to have, but her shop, she moved further away, and then she got a real dope setup where she ain't got to work every day. She got barbers under her, so it's hard to get that barber back. But anyway, this top five, yeah, I just don't remember time, like what's going on now, what I'm experiencing. So we're gonna get through it, and here's my top five. This is my top five, and if you agree, a lot of clients are probably gonna agree with this, because I heard from some people, we talk about these things sometimes, and barbers, you guys can jump in. And this is also, if you're a new barber, listen to this. Listen to us. Listen to the clients. Because we're paying you guys. So be professional. That's what this is mainly about. But I'm going to do a countdown. So starting at number five. Number five. Talking and laughing too much with other barbers and having this good old time. You're taking your hand off, you're talking, doing this. We dare to get a cut. Get with the cut. Get with the cut. That should be your whole time. Cut their hair. If y'all two are talking, that's cool, I guess. But if it's a guy who just want to be quiet, cut them. Don't come with 1,000 questions, ask them questions about this. Cut, man. We there just to cut. They're being quiet. If a client's being quiet, he just want to cut. But if y'all got a rapport, we all can talk and you can cut and it's dope, then that's your thing. But for the most part, professional. Barber, be professional. Cut their hair. Give them a dope lineup, hook it all up. That's all we're there for the most part. And I know the barbershop is this place where, you know, you go to chill, this, that, the other, but lately that has changed. Since COVID, all my appointments, everything is appointment now, which I'm cool with. I don't mind, because I really don't enjoy being in there. Like, I used to like to go chill. I like to get in there and get out, you know, so now it's just an appointment. I wait in my car till it's time to get my cut, and I get out of there. You know, I don't want to be there no longer than I have to be. And I remember when it was no appointment, so it used to be a long wait, man, if you didn't get there early. So now it's appointments, so that's cool. But that's five. All that talking, chit-chatting, laughing, having a good time with the other barbers, leaving, going off, talking, this, that, the other, going outside. I've seen one go outside before. Like, and I'm like, this other guy, wait to get his cut, he outside. So all of that, that's number five. Cut that out, be professional, cut the person's hair. And then I witnessed this one time, like maybe once or twice, but not that often, but double booking. Like you book for one time, you show up and he gotta talk to you, man. Let me holler at you, y'all. I got this guy right here. We gonna be real quick, and all that double booking. Like we ain't got nothing to do. Like our time ain't valuable. No, if you book, don't overbook. Stop being greedy. Book all the time that you can fit a person in, and that's that. A little overlay, you know, it might go over 1 or 2 minutes. Your time is for four, and he gotta get you, you know, 4:05. That's not too bad. Okay, we can work with that. But stop that double booking. That's number four. Number three, on the cell phone, or got two phones and doing other business. Stopping in the middle of the cut to take this call, to do that, the other. No. You at the job, get you a secretary, get somebody else to handle your other business. Be professional. This person's paying, we're paying you for the time that we're there to cut our hair, to get us right. Stop doing all this other business, stopping in the middle of the cut to go talk on your phone, or I gotta do this. If you, once or twice, you know, one time, like, yeah, man, I got something important going on, I have to, that's cool. If you let them know, like, okay, I got to do, no problem. But all the time, like, come on. Or somebody stopping in, and put this in with that. Somebody stopping in to see you and talk to you. like a family member or somebody. Nah, they ain't no respect, man. Our community, they ain't no respect when it comes to these barbershops. I ain't saying all, but I'm going by my experiences. And I know a lot of y'all experiencing this same stuff in these hood spots, these barbers, these shops. I know it. I know it. I know what's going on. I ain't the only one. I know it. I know it. Drop a comment. Barbers, you drop a comment. And this is for the new barbers, man. The way to be dope. And you don't get talked about because they'll leave. Your client will leave. And you may got a nice number of clients, but they'll leave. They'll leave you. Don't trust and believe there's other barbers out there. They'll leave you. But anyway, number two, to the weed smoking barbers. Don't have your hands and your breath smelling like weed. I witnessed this before and I never went back. This guy cut me, hands smelling like he just got done smoking the sticky icky. He was smelling like it and he could have been high, I don't know. The cut wasn't that great. I remember the cut not, but he was new. He just didn't get it right. And I just remember his hands, just the whole vibe, that whole cut was done. He never cut me again. He's still out there. I see him around. I see him on, you know, IG and stuff. They doing their thing. And they you can probably do your thing, but you will lose a client or more. You will lose a client or more. But yeah, so the sticky, icky, green hand smelling barber, don't be smelling like beer and alcohol. Be professional. It all comes back to professionalism. Somebody paying you, you're in their space to cut their hair. That's if you got a good client that tips well or whatever. Even if they don't tip you well, if they pay, if they tip you at all, because if they don't tip you, I'll go now. I'll stop the tip. If they mess up, that'd just be the pay, and then there you go. Good, because this is not a good cut. Or I'll get you back on the next one. Like if I get a bad cut this time, next one, no tip. I'll get you some kind of way. But it sucks, man. I talked to him, and yeah, I got you. You know, it's just, I'm done, man. It's just done. So that's number two. And my number one that I experienced, well, the backstory. I was going to this shop. One guy was cutting me, not getting great cuts, but I ain't had no other barber at the time. I saw another dude in the shop. I think I told this story in another video that cut dope. I'm like, okay. The time just worked out where I had left that shop, but then I circled back around to this shop because my barber moved or whatever, and the dude that I always wanted to cut me that I thought was cutting dope started cutting me, and he was dope. Dope cuts for the longest time. Then they start to decline. That's what I'm getting to with this video. They start in this number one. They start good, they real dope, paying attention, lineups dope, make sure they looking, checking the side, checking everything, make sure it even, taper, not everything good. Then they start declining over time. You start getting these hit or miss cuts where I'm like, yeah, I can work with it, but it's some are cool, but then the other ones, they just missing the mark or mistakes, just messing up or getting lazy. I think that's what it is. So I know recently, my barber, my lineup goes, you know, along the chin under here. He left the line with my line where it's supposed to be to where the hair was going back. He just did a quick little, didn't want to, seemed like he didn't want to bend over to, or lean me back just to take that look. I didn't really, and then in the shop, it's hard to see sometimes looking in the double mirror thing. Just, he missed the whole line under the chin, like the proper line where it should have been, where we used to do it. Like, and he has, like I said, declined over time. Just lackluster effort, not caring, I guess. Not caring or too tired. Because I usually catch him at the end of the day. He could be, but I don't know. But declining quality, that's probably my number one. All that other stuff is bad too. All that talking and chit-chatting. Like, give me a good cut, man. If you can cut and talk, do it. But going and chit-chatting with the other barbers and all these other things that we going through on with these barbershops and with the barber in the chair, shouldn't have to be dealing with. But number one is that decline over time, and I've experienced that in my current situation. Shout out to him, he's my homie, but man, oh man, this is I'm about to, like I said, I can cut my own hair. I'm about to go back to doing that for a little while, just until I figure this out, because it's issue, like little the beard stuff, like I can see is little things I'll have to go and do myself. I ain't get around to it, but I'm tired of getting the cut and then going back and not do my own cut again. So what's the point? I'm just gonna have to find something new. And I wish I had Wendy. She was the best, like I said. And other than my East Coast barbers, she was the best out here I experienced. Other than my current situation, dope. But over time, just seems to be hit or miss, not really paying that close attention. Like I have some other barbers, another barber out here that's dope. He really looks, he pays attention, but just timing and getting a slot. That fits in my time. That's the other thing. So I think I'm just going to be doing my own cut for a little while. Just fall back because I know how to do it and I've done it.
got a decent amount of practice with it, and I can cut my own. Ain't no thing, man. Just to fall back away from these barbers. But the main point in this video is just, if you're a new barber or an existing barber, man, professional. We just want somebody professional. This is our hair. This is our look. We're going out there and representing what you did. We get a compliment. Like, yeah, my barber's dope. I recommend them. But you get these whack cuts. Then I gotta talk about you. Gotta talk like, yo, this is no. Like, so this is the barber video, man. This is my top five. So number one was talking too much. I mean, five was talking too much. Four was the double booking. Three was the cell phone, messing with phones, too much texting, too much calls, just get too much, too many distractions. Yep. Two was hands smelling like the sticky icky or alcohol, whatever. None of that. Leave all of that aside. Say that for when you get off. Like I said, I don't want no weed cut. No, people may smoke, but they don't trust me. They don't want you high on their head. And I just get out of here. That's whack. That's lame. And then number one is that decline in quality over time. Stay sharp all throughout. Be good all the way through your career. So yeah, that's my top five. This is KUT. It's the KUT Productionz video. Hit that like button. Subscribe to the channel. I talk about hip hop, vinyl records. I do some events, all kind of stuff. And I'll do a rant like this once in a while or top something. But barbers, get it together. Barbers, I want to hear from you. Clients, if you get cuts and you experience any of this, drop a comment down below. All right, y'all, we out of here. Peace.